Welcome back to the channel, where we continue along helping small and medium-sized businesses and marketing teams make that transition to Google Analytics 4 or GA4. A lot of people and marketing departments are slow to make that adjustment. They're used to the Universal Analytics, but once you actually get inside GA4, there are more opportunities to mine your data, to create events, to track conversions that will help you with your digital marketing return on investment. Now, real-time reports are located in the report snapshot on your left-hand column. And real-time reports, some of the main metrics that you can track is you can take a look at your 30-minute snapshot of your visitors to your website or app. Remember, GA4 can be used if you do have an app for your website or for your company. Now, you can also track users by source, medium, and campaign, which will help you on different conversions, if they're filling out forms, if they're purchasing, if you have an e-commerce website, what they're purchasing, and the total volume of purchases, even a lifetime value, if you want to track that by user ID. You can also track your different events, whether they're clicking on buttons, tracking forms, visiting pages, if you have some custom goals set up, or even some goals where they follow a funnel, like they come to your homepage, then they go to the About Us page, and then maybe they download a white paper or something like that. So you can track a lot of that in your real-time reports, and users by page title. Those are just a few of the many different reports. Now, this is what your real-time report looks like. It's kind of a snapshot of where your visitors are from in the last 30 minutes. In this example, there's been 4 visitors in the 30 minutes preceding. 75% of them were mobile, and desktop was 25%. And then the location, again, this is by the IP address. So in this example, New York, North Carolina, Chicago, and 3 of the 4 visitors were on a mobile device. You can also check your acquisition, the engagement, and the monetization, again, if you have an e-commerce website. And if you don't have an e-commerce website, that's where you set up your conversions to determine the metrics that matter for your website, and then track week over week, month over month, and on certain days if it's improving. Now, the benefits of monitoring your real-time reports in GA4, if there's any issues with the site, you can see that, you know, if something doesn't look right with your traffic patterns, if there's any promotions driving traffic, maybe you're doing a Saturday morning promotion, maybe you're doing a Friday promotion on Black Friday or Cyber Monday, email promotions, you can see if that traffic's coming in from your email, coupon promotions, what they're clicking on after they come in by the campaign, and you can also monitor any special advertising on a page or your traffic content with GA4. And what probably the main reason that I use GA4 is to track any new tracking code for the real-time reports. You can go in there in your real-time, and if you're one of the few visitors, or if you're a visitor in a specific location, you can see if it's tracking your tracking code from Google Tag Manager. One of the things that you do need to establish early on, whether it's Universal Analytics or GA4, is make sure you're aware of the difference between the source and a medium. This is probably the biggest differentiator between new users to Google Analytics and experienced users. The source of the traffic is the specific origin. So that is where they came from, whether it's Google or Microsoft or a website referral or a display traffic. And the medium is the category of traffic. This is more where you start putting them in buckets, whether it's email, display, pay-per-click, social media, and direct traffic. Those are some examples of your medium of traffic, and that's kind of where you want to put them into those categories of buckets. Now, GA4, another benefit is you can quickly generate reports, you can exclude traffic. There is a little bit of a learning curve from Universal Analytics, but once you get in there and use it on a consistent basis, your learning curve will definitely go up. Now, again, Some of the things that you can track with GA4 that you can't in Universal Analytics are page views, specific page views, form fills, outbound clicks, file downloads, button clicks, and it's just a lot easier using Google Tag Manager. And you definitely want to make sure that you've got these set up. I would say about 50% of the accounts I look at, people are not tracking all of the measurable things. So that's one of the things that I do. If you want to work with me, leave a note, connect with me on LinkedIn. First, do an audit of your website, look at the purpose of your website, and then make sure that you're tracking on Google Analytics. Universal Analytics and GA4 can run side by side. You can also build your audience builders for website retargeting and A/B testing of landing pages if you're using GA4 as an upgrade over Universal Analytics. So real-time reports, they're important. Make sure to get connected up. I do got a video on connecting up from Universal Analytics to GA4 in 4 quick, easy steps. Leave a comment. What has been your experience with GA4 so far?